I'm pretty sure it's Jigglypuff. It might be Mewtwo, but I think it's Puff, yeah.
It is going to be Jigglypuff. Okay, so...
I knew it was one of the two broken Pokemon.
Ugh.
Mewtwo and Jigglypuff.
Oh, I don't even want to think about Jigglypuff. Aphex just makes me hate that character so much.
Did you lose to Aphex and Jigglypuff?
He just... All he does
did
is...
Did you lose to Aphex and Jigglypuff?
No, I did not.
Oh, damn it.
He almost... Okay, he almost had a match in Game 3 where he rested me 4 times to win.
That's... fantastic.
I was almost about to cry.
I love that.
But then he missed the last one. I was just like, oh, thank God.
The first week that Smash 4 was out on 3DS, I didn't use a character besides Jigglypuff until the game had been out for 7 days.
Yeah.
The only character I used for the first week was Jigglypuff.
Why would you do that to yourself?
I don't know. I don't know why I did that. I didn't like Jigglypuff in any other past game. It's just for some reason I looked at the CSS the first time and I was like, I'm going for this guy.
This is Jigglypuff.
And then after I tried her once, I couldn't stop. Like, I wanted to continue what I... figuring out what I was trying
so
to figure out.
So what you're saying is Extraordinary was almost a dedicated Jigglypuff main.
Yeah, I switched instead to a dedicated Ganondorf main. Well, I wouldn't say dedicated, but I mained Ganondorf.
And then you went to Falcon, now you're Ryu. And
now yeah, I tried Jigglypuff, Ganondorf, Wii Fit Trainer, and Samus before I finally got onto Falcon, the first non-bottom tier character that I tried. I guess Samus probably isn't bottom tier, but at the time she was thought to be for like the longest time. And then I finally got to Falcon. This is Jigglypuff, man.
Yeah, that was a good catch on the jump there by MW.
Yeah.
And I don't know how this match would be. It's two really floaty characters. Both are generally considered kind of lame-ish.
Yeah, it would be really hard for somebody who doesn't use one of these characters to have any insight on this matchup. I mean, unless you come from a very weird region where you have a top Jigglypuff and Lucas on like your PR.
Wow, that fair killed, though.
That fair normally doesn't kill because it's got a good base knockback, but its growth is kind of slow. But on a character as light as Jigglypuff, then,
it wouldn't really matter. Uh-oh.
Oh, man.
That was...
Went back to the stage.
Yeah, that was still a really good idea by MW. But Lucas's recovery is super good.
Man, that back air was really perfectly spaced. Just keep doing it. Oh.
And it's not the same as Ness's lair. It's just... It fizzes out immediately.
Yeah.
It's active. It takes a lot to get rid of that BK Thunder.
We also did a good job of keeping this...
Oh, no. Yeah,
I guess it's very doable for him still.
Yeah. Whoa, what? That was a... Who does Jigglypuff jab?
He didn't grab the ledge? I feel like that wasn't very fair, but...
That
down smash is
have
cool.
Have you ever seen Jigglypuff do down smash? I have never seen a down smash
I've
before.
Seen down smash, just not a two-frame down
smash.
I've
never seen everyone actually go for it.
I do it too much when I use Jigglypuff. Because its knockback angle is amazing, and I usually play against Captain Falcon.
Oh, yeah. I can understand that. Yeah, that angle was so ridiculous.
No, that time it just... didn't want to grab the edge because those feet were there, and they're like scary.
I don't feel like it.
Scary. Jigglypuff feet.
Ew. I don't know where those feet have been.
I know that they hurt.
They do hurt.
Hey, Ness is here. You said dedicated Lucas, liar.
I this is new to me, man. I'm sorry. Sometimes, like, I just get new random info out of nowhere.
I like Ness for this because as far as the two of them, Ness with his kill throw and Lucas with his throw combos, I think against a character that's difficult to combo like Jigglypuff, you're much better
just
with a grab that kills than with a grab that tries to combo. Because I don't know if you even can. I don't think you can do the Lucas footstool stuff against Jigglypuff.
It would be a really weird window.
Yeah, and then she's got like the most aerial mobility after a footstool too, so it'd be really hard to follow where she lands.
Oh yeah.
And so.
Oh no. That got
whereas it. Ness's grab benefits work even more against Jigglypuff than they do against a lot of characters. If you can manage to get the grab, probably kills.
Yeah, because since Ness can just go for 1-2s anyway. After
that is
down
that
throw.
Is my very black and white analysis of this matchup from an outsider who knows nothing about the inner workings of either of these characters. I would say Ness would be better than Lucas.
Yeah, but at the same time, like...
I have no confidence in that. That's my guess.
Yeah, this
If
this
I
is,
had to guess, I'd pick Ness.
This is my guess from Jigglypuff's perspective. You get better edge guarding against Ness since you don't have the tether like with Lucas.
No tether, that's true.
And then...
And that's it.
Yeah, that's pretty straightforward, but that forward smash is going to catch.
Man, MW...
just calling out these
that
landings.
Game too, he won it quite dominantly. I think it's my turn to go lose even worse than VL just
have some faith in yourself, man.
Oh, I have no faith in myself. Against Nebula? None whatsoever.